In this video, we're going to construct a 95% confidence interval for a proportion. We'll look at an example involving dog ownership. In spring 2016, a sample of 522 World Campus students were surveyed and asked if they own a dog. Of the 522 students in the sample, 273 said that they did have a dog. Construct a 95% confidence interval for the proportion of all World Campus students who have a dog. In this scenario, we're given that n equals 522. We can compute p hat, the sample proportion, by dividing 273 by 522. Our sample proportion is 0.523. Before we construct our confidence interval, we should check assumptions. Recall that in order to use the normal approximation method, both n times p and n times 1 minus p must be greater than or equal to 10. In our scenario, we were given that n equals 522, and we computed p hat to be 0.523. Since we don't have the population proportion, we're going to use the sample proportion as an estimate. N times p hat equals 522 times 0.523. This equals 273. In other words, there were 273 students in this sample who said yes, they own a dog. N times 1 minus p hat equals 522 times 1 minus 0.523. This is 249. There were 249 students in this sample who said no, they do not own a dog. Both n times p hat and n times 1 minus p hat are greater than or equal to 10, so this assumption has been met. We can use the normal approximation method. Here's our formula for the confidence interval of p. We're going to learn a number of confidence intervals this semester, and they all take on the same general form. The sample statistic, in this case, the sample proportion, plus or minus the multiplier. Because we're using the normal approximation method here, this is a z multiplier, times the standard error. First, let's look up our z multiplier. We're constructing a 95% confidence interval, so we need to find the z scores that separate the middle 95% from the outer 5%. Using Minitab Express, I constructed a distribution plot and found that these z scores are plus and minus 1.95996. We'll round to 1.960. This is the formula for the standard error of the sample proportion. You were first introduced to this in the last lesson. In our scenario, the standard error of p hat equals the square root of 0.523 times 1 minus 0.523 divided by 522. This equals 0.0219. Now we have all the values that we need to construct our 95% confidence interval. We can plug these values into the formula, and we get 0.523 plus or minus 1.96 times 0.0219. Our point estimate is the sample proportion of 0.523, and our margin of error is equal to 0.043. Our confidence interval is 0.480 to 0.566. These are two examples of how you may see this confidence interval written. The interpretation is that I am 95% confident that the proportion of dog owners in the population of all World Campus students is between 48.0% and 56.6%.